Today, we're going to learn about the concept of speed. What I have here is a ticker tape timer. It has a plunger that makes 50 dots in 1 second at a constant frequency. I'm going to switch on the car now and the ticker tape, and we're going to capture the motion map. I'm going to set up the ticker tape for the next motion. I'm going to attach the tape to the car. This time round, it's going to move across an obstacle. And we're ready to go. I have laid the motion tape side by side for analysis purpose. So we shall now go into the motion maps. The first tape captured the motion of a car at a constant motion without the obstacle. The second tape captured the motion of the car moving across the obstacle. When the car was moving along here, the spacing between markings on both tapes are the same. From the point where the car strikes the obstacle, you can see that the spacing gets narrower. And once it crossed over to the peak, it started to space out and become wider. Finally, as the car cleared the obstacle, the one without obstacles and the one with obstacles, they have equal spacing. The spacing has an indication on the speed of the car. If the spacing gets wider, it's an indication that the distance covered per unit time is faster. And whereas the spacing, if it's narrower, it shows that the distance covered per unit time is less, which is also an indication that the speed is lower. Today, we have learned about the concept of speed as distance covered per unit time.